If you're using no-code automation, you absolutely must know how to use a webhook. This is a slightly more advanced concept within no-code, but it unlocks amazing possibilities for you once you master this skill. In this video, I'm going to be breaking down using a webhook between an Airtable button push and connecting that webhook to Zapier so that when a button is pushed in Airtable, we trigger an automation. If learning about that is of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. We make it our mission to help you get the most out of your no-code tools, and Airtable and Zapier, they are at the forefront of our most favorite no-code tools in the space. Now, as I mentioned, we're going to be diving into using webhooks in this particular video. But before we get into it, I want to first invite you to join me for some free automation training. If you're new to no-code automation, or if you need a refresher on the basic core principles, check out my free training, gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration is where you can sign up. And that free training will be made available to you immediately. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen. We have to start by first outlining what we are trying to accomplish. So here we have inside of Airtable, two different tables built. I've got customers and I'm linking those customers to invoices. So on an invoice, we track the invoice ID, we know the customer name or the customer that it's linked to, and we know the amount of the invoice. We also know what date this was due, and lastly, we are tracking the status, whether paid or unpaid. So what we are envisioning here is that we've got a bit of a dashboard where we're looking at a list of our customers, and we can see all of the stuff that they have yet to pay us. And just with a simple button push, we can send out a templated email that says, hey, we noticed we haven't heard back from you just yet. We want to make sure that you know that these two invoices or these three invoices are still outstanding. This is the total that you owe us, etc. So what kind of information do we need in order to facilitate this? Well, number one, we're going to need to store an email address. So this should live at the customer level. If we don't have this information, then it really is going to be impossible for us to perform the automation itself. Now, for the sake of our video, I'm going to include my own email here so that we can test this out and verify that it's working for our different customers or clients. Now, another component that we might want to bring in here is when did we last contact this particular customer? Because we don't want to pepper them with the same email over and over again if they are maybe in the process of paying. So we can put a last contacted here and we're going to make this a date field. So we can update this when we contact them. So every time we push that button, every time we initiate our automation, we're going to come back here and update it with a timestamp. Okay, so also of note is that we have a couple of rollup fields and lookup fields here. So the rollup field, it's looking at our linked invoices. It's looking at that secondary table and it's saying, I'm going to look at the amount of the invoices and I'm going to include them. I'm going to sum them up if the status is not paid, therefore it's unpaid, and if the due date is in the past or today, right? So if an invoice is not yet due, it will not be included in this amount due. Also, we have the lookup field. It's very similar in nature, except what we're doing here is bringing up the invoice ID. So we're saying the same two conditions. If it's not paid and if it's past due, right, the due date is on or before today. Let's make that on or before. In this case, we're going to include that invoice number here. So here, if we go over to our invoices and we group them really quickly by customer, we see that we have two invoices for each customer. But not all of those invoices are being brought back here, and therefore not all of those invoices are being totaled here. The reason for that, if we look at them, will be because they're either paid or they're not yet due. So here, for example, we are not seeing two invoices for beta. We see 1005, we can click into this, and we see it's unpaid and it's past due, right? But if we flip over here and we look at 1002, it's paid. So we're not going to see it listed on that, and it's not going to be included in the amount due. Same thing over here for Delta, except the difference here is, as of my recording, it's May 14th, and this is saying, hey, This is due on May 16th, therefore it's not being included as well. So a lot of this logic is being built in the back end of Airtable already. But now what we want to do is get to the point where we put together an interface. Now I've already put something light together for us. We can see it right here that we've got a list by customer, and each customer is showing the invoices underneath it, and we can see the status, what the date is, the amount, etc. Now, there are many ways that we could come at this problem, but ultimately what we want is at a customer level to add this button, a button right here on our interface that we can just push for this customer, and then another one down here that we can push for this customer, etc. Let's also be sure to bring in that last contacted field that we added. So now we can see the last time that we actually reached out to them, and we can look at this and compare it to today's date and therefore not spam people with this automation. So now that we're ready, let's create that new field. I'm gonna name this send email, and it will be a button field type. Now inside the button, we're giving it an action of opening a URL, and we're going to give it a webhook here, and we're going to append that webhook with the record ID from Airtable. Now let's hop into Zapier and actually get that webhook going. So inside of Zapier, I can create a new automation. In Zapier, these are called zaps. So I'll say new zap here. Now you might be asking yourself why you would do this externally from Airtable. Now, yes, it's true, you can build a lot of automation in Airtable, but for the more advanced use cases, especially when you start integrating with more nuanced software out there, it's very valuable to know how to do this in Zapier, because very often you will require third-party integration to do that more advanced automation within no code. So here I can set up a trigger, and my trigger is going to be the webhook. Note that this is a premium feature from Zapier, so I do need to be on a premium tier. A free account will not cut it. Now, my event that I'm going to choose here is going to be a catch hook. And basically what this is going to do is give us a URL. Think of it as like a phone number. So when we are ready to trigger this automation, all we have to do is call the phone number, and that will set things going. So we're going to copy this to our clipboard and head back into Airtable now, and I'm going to use a formula to paste this in. Note that I've done this inside of quotations, either single or double quotations in my Airtable formula. Now what I want to add to this is going to be a parameter. I want to include the record URL as well. So outside of all of this, I'm going to actually wrap this around with a concatenate formula. And inside, I'm actually going to break this up for us so that we can see this a little bit more easily. That's my first piece, is going to be the webhook itself. Then I follow it with a comma. And the next part is going to be some more text. Question mark, rec ID equals. Now, again, note that that's inside of single or double quotes. And now for the last piece here, I'm going to, after another comma, call upon my record ID. So what is this formula really doing? Well, in short, it's saying I'm gonna call that webhook, I'm passing a value, this variable that we have now named rec ID, and then the value of that record ID is going to be the record ID itself. So check this out. We're gonna create this field, and I now have this little button. Now, of course, I could update this button to say whatever I'd like, but if we flip back into Zapier, we see that it's listening. We wanna test the trigger and see if it finds anything. Now, it hasn't heard anything yet. So let's come back here and push the button. Now, you'll notice that this opens up in a new window, and this part is unavoidable if you're using this approach, but I can easily just close down this window, no problem here. And back inside of Zapier, I will test the trigger again. And if we got this correct, which we did, we see that we received this information. So here is the request that was received by the webhook. And it's saying, hey, we actually, not only did we get a phone call put into this phone number, but I also received this record ID. And we see that it was given this value of rec ID right here. So how is this helpful for us? Well, now we can go on and do more steps inside of Airtable. I can again sync up with my Airtable base here. And if this is the first time that you've ever connected Airtable, you're gonna have to go through and set up your account. But the event that I'm looking for, you'll see I got a lot of different options here. I can do an API request. update a record, create records with line item support, etc. What I want to do is just find the record. I know what record I pushed the button from. I know what the customer record was, so let's find it. And I can say continue here, and this is where we need to connect our account. So I'm going to go ahead and get it set up. Once you've connected your account, you can then select the base, which in our case, I named Webhook example, and you have to pick the table where you're going to find this information. For us, that's in our customers table. Now, we do need to perform a search here, and we're going to search by a field, right? And we don't have a field called record ID just yet. So let's flip back into Airtable. Let's go back to our data itself, and inside of our customers table, we're going to build that record ID. And we can use an easy formula. This one's much simpler than the last one. It's just record ID, open, close parenthesis. So now we have an actual output, a field that we can search that involves or includes the record ID. Back in Zapier now, I can actually refresh this data. I'll find the new field that I just added, and I can now look up this information. So the value, the search value that I want to include here is the record ID that was passed in the webhook. So let's kind of retrace our steps, right? We push a button, we're triggering the webhook, which initiates the automation. We're also in that same moment passing along a record ID. So then in the next step of our automation, we're saying, I know the record ID, go back into my record ID field in Airtable, in the customer table, and find the record that I just pushed the button for. Is it an exact match? It better be. A record ID is always unique, and we can use this step. So let's go ahead and continue here and test the step. This is going to use the data that we had from the previous step, and it's going to search for that record, the customer record in Airtable. Just like that, we now have all of the information that we need in order to complete our automation. We have the different invoices right here. We see 1001 and 1004 remain overdue. We see the total amount that is due. The field here that we rolled up is 14,000 for this particular customer. We have the email address that we should be sending this automation to. We have all the information we need to make sure that we follow up. Now, in the interest of time, I'm going to talk through the remaining steps of the automation. First of all, we would send the email. We would craft an email that includes this information. And if we needed to, we could even look up more information about these invoices because we have the record IDs for the invoices right here. And of course, the last component of this automation would be to go back into our customers table and, as part of the automation, update this date with today's date, taking a timestamp from Zapier so that we could then mark it and say, hey, we just reached out to these people on May 14th. Let's not do it again. Don't push that button again for a while. I know we went pretty fast in this video and covered quite a lot, so any questions you have, be sure to drop them below. And in the meantime, my friends, keep on building.